techno update. Subscribe now.
Kabaura H2O review. Design. Design is an essential component when considering a new tech product that will satisfy your needs. The Kabaura H2O device is 179 by 129 by 9.7 mm and 233 grams, which is quite large in comparison to others in its category, namely, Amazon's newest and thinnest Kindle Oasis. Despite the larger size and weight, I found the Kabaura H2O quite comfortable to hold. I did, however, prefer a two-handed grip to a single-handed one. Others readers may enjoy the latter. As mentioned above, what sets the Kabaura H2O apart from competitors is its waterproof nature. Amazon has yet to release a waterproof version of the Kindle, aside from a waterproof case that users can purchase in addition. Display. The OR has a large, high-resolution 1430 by 1080 display with 265px. I didn't have to strain my eyes and could read the text comfortably. Other Kabaura models, such as the Aura 1, have slightly more pixels per inch, 300, meaning that the sharpness in detail is a bit more than the Aura H2O. The difference in resolution is minuscule, so readers would likely notice a difference. The Aura H2O does, however, offer a brilliant feature within its 6.8-inch Carta E-Ink HD touchscreen called Comfort Light. Comfort Light is a built-in, fully adjustable front light with micro-thin coating. It acts as an ambient light sensor to automatically adjust brightness and temperature based on the environment of the reader. Hardware. The Aura H2O has a 4GB onboard memory, which allows for the storage of up to 3,000 titles. The more expensive Kabaura 1 has double the storage capacity at 8GB, however, the Aura H2O provides an option to expand to 32GB with the purchase of an additional microSD card. Battery. Kabaura advertises the battery life of its Aura H2O as capable of lasting for weeks. This is a vague description, but e-readers can generally go a few weeks without needing a recharge. We found the Aura lasted absolutely ages, true to its word.